Academic series by CRPF Public School.
Hello students, I'm back once again for you all. Academic series launched by CRPF Public School is a venture for recapitulation for all the topics we have done in the class. Today, I'll take up the topic helping verbs, also known as auxiliary verbs. Helping verbs or the auxiliary verbs are used to form tenses, voices of other verbs. Now, example is am, are, was, were, have, had, do, does, did. Now, these all examples are the form of auxiliary verbs. Now, the biggest confusion which students do, or actually even the adults sometimes, is the formation with the present form of be or the past form of be. Do you know? Be is a very important auxiliary verb. Now, present form of be, what do we use? Is, am, are. Past form of be, was or were. Now, one thing I would like to explain you here. Many times, the verb itself acts as the main verb. In that condition, they do not help any other verb, but act as a main verb. You know what are they called? They are called notional verbs. For example, I have a book. He is my brother. You are a bad boy. I am a good girl. I am not a rich man. In these sentences, all the verbs act as a main verb. Now, let's come to the uses of auxiliary verbs. First, I'll take the use of is. Always remember, is mainly used in present continuous tense. Is used in the formation of continuous tense. And is comes with the subjects. Subjects, he, she, it, and singular nouns. So the format becomes subject plus is plus first form of the verb along with ing and then the object for completion of the sentence. Let me repeat. Subject, then comes is, then comes first form of the verb with ing and then the object for completion of the sentence. For example, he is learning English. Who is learning English? He. So he becomes the subject. Is the auxiliary verb. Learn is the first form of the verb combined with ing. English becomes the subject, becomes the subject which is being learned, so is the object in the sentence. So he is learning English. Is helping in making the present continuous tense. It is raining. Rohan is playing cricket. So now I hope the use of is clear to you, and we'll proceed with the use of and now. Students, as we were doing the use of is, let's do the use of am, another auxiliary verb. Use of am, I'm sure you all know, the subject becomes I. So the format becomes subject plus am plus first form of the verb plus ing and then the object for the completion of the sentence. Remember children, always write complete sentence and completion is along with the object. Want some examples? Let me give you some examples. I am going to the market. I am learning English. I am eating a mango. I'm sure you all love mangoes, especially it's summers. Anyhow, so let's continue with the usage of am. So I'm sure you are clear with the usage of am. When I say it comes with the subject, I. Coming on to the use of are, another auxiliary verb. Are is used with the subject, you, plural nouns, me, we, they. These all subjects are combined with the auxiliary verb are. So the format becomes subject, are, then first form of the verb along with ing, and then the object for the completion of sentence. For example, we are going to the market. We all are going to the market. We are learning English. They are playing cricket. Ram and Rahul are writing a letter. So these were the examples where we have used auxiliary verb are. Let's come to the use of do. Now do comes with the subject I, we, they, you, or plural nouns. You do look pale. I do love to go to the market. So do becomes the auxiliary verb with these subjects. Another auxiliary verb is does. Let's see how we use does.